Here we're going to bring together our safe access to objects, object properties, and our validation that we have some kind of default value instead of returning undefined, as well as the way to inspect those things from a maybe perspective to deal with both scenarios of when we have something and when we don't. In this case, we are going to look at a request object. This is a very, very common thing to do in the backend, and it's also very dynamic. There's no guarantee that you have the things you're looking for in the right way you're looking for them, because it's from a third-party source. That's not even from your code, and they might not have very stringent ways of dealing with UR. Maybe they have errors. Who knows? And so you need to be very, very controlled around these things, even if you don't have strong typing. What we're doing today is we're going to verify that we have an authorization header, which is how you authorize between different services, usually using some centralized OAuth server. This bearer token is what's used as kind of like a temporary username and password. So instead of having your username and password in the request and deal with encryption, you actually get this token. It's temporary, very easy to generate, usually lasts about 2 weeks. And if you want to get a new one, it really doesn't take that long. Cache these things, leave them around, and leave them in your request. But there's no guarantee they're there, and there's no guarantee that they're even legit. So we're going to verify that we even have a bearer token in our request. We're not going to validate it and say, look, if you have it, we're going to go ahead and make the HTTP request for you. If we don't, we're going to tell you why and give you a nicer, you know, error message as to what's going on. But more important is that we're going to do it in a safe way. So we're not going to deal with the problems of undefined on the downstream inspecting and parsing these things. And we're going to deal with maybes and bring about a safe object get. So the way we do that is the first thing we do is we use a safe get. So we do a headers.authorization. So if headers doesn't even exist in this object, that's okay. The load-get will verify that it's safe and give you an undefined if not. If we get a token back and it is a string, then we can safely do the string operations. If it's not a string, then we just go ahead and return nothing. It means it's not there or it's just not in a type that we expect. If it is there, we can go ahead and safely do a split if it's a string. The problem is we can't safely access the second operation of it because if you split on an empty string and the thing isn't there, well, let's just say it's a comma, for example, which doesn't exist in a blank string, you only get an array of one item. So we're going to use the get or, which is very similar to get, to safely access object one. And if it's not there and undefined in this case, provide an empty string. That way, when we call length on it, it's nice and safe, doesn't break. And we're trying to verify that it's greater than or equal to 64, which is generally a good size for a token. If all of those pass, then we return a just true. Two things to note here. First, it's a maybe, and every single undefined and safeness is handled here, so we don't have to worry about null pointer exception. If we've reached this point, not only do we have a valid value, but it's also safe at this point. But we don't want to actually expose the token, so we just say true. If any of those fail for whatever reason, we return a nothing. So now we can basically say, look, if you have a bearer token on the request, you either do, or we couldn't detect it for a variety of reasons. Now again, this is not very nuanced, but it's very, very safe. So let me go ahead and run this example and show you that we have a bearer token, but if we, let's say, mess it up for whatever reason, it's not the correct length, it says no bearer token detected. It might look like one, but it's not really detected. If we remove the space and try to mess up our parsing, that won't break. We can even change the name and it doesn't care about that. We can even remove it entirely. And again, our code is super safe. And so again, this is how you combine the concepts of safe gets with a default value, and then returning a maybe to handle both scenarios. And understand what it really means. Change what that means in the context of calling that function.